Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video we'll be taking a look at TowerTale and I'll be giving my overall opinions whether you should buy this game or not. Spoiler alert, I really like this game. The normal sort of games that I review on this channel, they are like small indie games and they all have their own sort of unique quirks. For instance, there's a lot of indie games that when you load it up, you'll get a sub menu that, you know, will tell you to pick the graphics ahead of time and tell you to pick the ratio, and it feels very cheap. Whereas this game, it just loads up like, you know, like any game should. And when the game does load up, you're greeted with this beautiful artwork and this amazing soundtrack. So even before I started playing, this game already gave me a good first impression. So what is TowerTale, you're probably asking yourself by now? Well, TowerTale is a 2D platformer boss battling game. There are 12 bosses in the game, each boss being slightly more difficult than the previous one. But it's what happens in between the boss battles where this game really shines. I would almost compare it to a visual novel, but me comparing this to a visual novel game, you know, it might put a lot of people off. So what I will compare it to is, if you've played a game like Soul Calibur, where it's basically just an action game, but each character has its own individual story, and every time you defeat a boss, you're treated to, you know, either more cutscene or more dialogue. And this game is very similar in that regard. You have four characters to pick from, and each character has its own story. And if you want to learn more about that particular character, you know, you're going to have to get past these bosses. You're able to play this game with mouse and keyboard or a controller. For this footage I'm using an Xbox 360 controller. Each character pretty much handles the same. Your Y button is your ranged attack. Your B button is normally a dash or, you know, some way to make up ground or put distance between you and the boss. A is to jump and X is going to be your normal attack. And before I forget, you can also crouch by holding down on the direction pad or thumbstick. So onto the boss battles. Each boss has multiple phases. What that basically means is the boss has extra lives. They all have a very simple attack. It's very easy to adapt to. But once you kill the boss and it comes back for its second phase, it's normally just like an enhanced version of what it was doing the first time. So it will still be the same routine, but they'll change it up a bit. They'll either throw an extra move in or something in the environment will happen. It just adds an extra challenge for you. I'm gonna take a shot in the dark and say the game developers were inspired by Cuphead when it comes to the boss battles. They've kept it very simple, but the challenge is there. What I'm about to say doesn't make any sense. The combat is very, very easy, but it's also very hard at the same time. I know it doesn't make sense, but I'm sure we've all played a game where you get to a boss and you know the routine. You're saying to yourself, like, I know I can beat this guy, it's easy, but he just keeps destroying me. That's what this game's like. It's easy, but hard. When it comes to game modes, when you first load it up, you're going to have three options available to yourself. You're going to have story mode, which is what we've just been talking about. You've got arcade mode, which is more score orientated. So you fight all the bosses, but you don't get any of the story in between. But what you're doing is you're trying to clear the boss as quickly as possible. You know, you're trying to finish the boss with as much health. And all that goes together to put yourself on global leaderboards. So, you know, there's a bit of competitive edge here to this game as well. And the last game mode that you've got is free mode, which is basically practice mode on any of the bosses that you've already unlocked. So, you know, if you get to a certain boss on story mode and you just can't get past him, you can jump out, go into free mode and just, you know, keep practicing against that particular boss. The game also comes with achievements, which some people like, some people don't. I'm one of those people who likes his achievements. Now, when it comes to small indie games and achievements, what normally happens is they normally put like really easy achievements in, and it attracts people to buy the game just to you know, get an easy 100%. I'll save you the trouble if you're one of those people. This is not going to be one of those games that's going to be easy to 100%. And that pretty much wraps it up. There's not really much more I can say about it. It's a beautiful, simple game, and I'd recommend it to pretty much anyone who, you know, likes indie games. At the time of launch, the game currently has an offer on Steam, but even at its full retail price, the game is brilliantly priced. To sum it up, this game's got everything going for it, apart from a bit of coverage. I'm only a small YouTube channel, but I hope I encourage at least, you know, one or two people to go over and actually check this game out, because it is really good. And I'll even let you into a secret. So on my tags on Steam, I have the anime tag cancelled out. So basically what that means is when I look on my storefront, any game that's tagged with anime, it just gets filtered out. Like, I never see it. It's just, you know, like, this guy doesn't want to see anything with anime, so we will never show him anything. So the only way that I actually found this was through the curator page that I am a part of on Steam. So I decided to have a look today to see if there's any games waiting to be reviewed that were in my sort of genre. And this one sort of stood out to me. And if it wasn't by accident, I probably would never have played this game. So don't always judge a book by its cover. Thanks for watching, I hope you've enjoyed the video, and see you next time.